Hello friends of electrical motors, there are two types of windings for electrical motors. Today I will show you the advantages and the disadvantages of the two types of windings. Additionally, I will also tell you from which winding you will get a higher torque and from which winding you will get a better efficiency. So let's get started. Windings for electrical motors can be divided into concentrated winding and distributed windings. In a distributed winding, the winding is always wound over at least two stator teeth, as shown here in the example. In a concentrated winding, on the other hand, only one stator tooth is wound. The best way to compare this is to imagine the stator split open. Before I forget, subscribe to the channel and activate the bell that you do not miss any new videos in the future. Here you can see the transformation of the round stator into a simplified view. The dark gray are the stator teeth and the windings are wound around them. The light gray is the stator back ring and the orange are the windings. The windings usually consist of several turns and of course they have a beginning and an end. As you can see, in a concentrated winding, one stator tooth carry exactly one winding. The different colors stands for the three phases, U, V and W. The two windings of one phase are connected to each other, and the three phases can be then connected to a star or a delta. With a distributed winding, at least two teeth are wound, as shown in this example. Over how many teeth are wound is called coil span. And of course, you can also wind over 3, 4, 5 or more teeth. You can find a link with more examples of winding configuration in the description. You can see with a distributed winding, the windings overlap at the upper and lower end. This area of the motor is also called winding head. Because of the overlapping, the winding head is larger at distributed winding than with a concentrated winding. Therefore, a concentrated winding is usually used for very short electrical motors. In this way, the ohmic losses from the winding head can be reduced. Wheel hub drives for bicycles are therefore almost manufactured with concentrated windings, because they are short and have a large diameter. It is also easier and less expensive to manufacture a stator with a concentrated winding. At longer electric motors, the influence of the losses from the winding head is not so big in the relation to the total losses. So, electrical motors with a concentrated winding are shorter and easier to manufacture. But why do almost all large car manufacturers use distributed windings for their electric vehicles? Let's take a look at the back EMF of a distributed winding and a concentrated winding. The back EMF is the voltage that you can measure at the terminals of an electric motor with permanent magnets, when the motor is rotated fast enough by hand. As you can see, the voltage of the electric motor with the distributed winding is nicely sine-shaped. On the other hand, the back EMF of the concentrated winding is rather than a shape of a trapezoid. What does this mean for the performance of the motor? A motor with a concentrated winding can generate more torque due to the trapezoid back EMF. However, the losses in the copper and the sheet metal are bigger because there are more and higher harmonics. With a distributed winding, you can achieve a higher efficiency due to the sinus wave back EMF, which is very important for electric vehicles. However, it does not directly mean that if an electric motor has a sinus wave back EMF, that this motor has a high efficiency. And also with concentrated windings, a sinus wave back EMF can be achieved by adjusting the rotor design. Other distinguishing features which are important for the design of the winding are fractional and integer slot windings, as well as single layer and double layer. For this, I would make an extra video or about the production of the windings. Let me know in the comments which video would help you more. Of course, I would be very happy if you help me by sharing the video with your friends and colleagues on LinkedIn and Twitter. And of course, like it if you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching and I wish you all an excellent efficiency.